friends, so today we are gonna see that how to find the trigonometric angle without using the calculator. It means, let's say if I ask you what is the cosine of 3660 degree. So the angle is very large, and if you want to find out the cosine of that large angle, then what is the trick? So today we are gonna discuss that trick which will give you the trigonometric value for any large angle. Now how to get it? So basically it is a two-step process. So let's understand the step 1 and step 2, and then we'll find it out. So step 1 is called as identify the quadrant. So here you can see that I have drawn the 4 quadrant system, where in the first quadrant we say that all trigonometric ratios are positive. In second quadrant we say that the sine and cosec are positive. In the third quadrant the tan is positive, and because of tan the cot is positive. And similarly in the fourth quadrant the cos and sec are positive. So hence I have written A for all, S for sine and cosec, T for tan and cot, and C for cos and sec. Now my friends, if you want to remember this ASTC system, then I will give you one more formula, and that is, you can say that add sugar to coffee. So what does it mean? You have to remember the first letter of each word. So here A in add, S in sugar, T into, and C in coffee. So this ASTC is nothing but our letters which will denote the quadrants. So add sugar to coffee will give me the formula for ASTC. Now here I am gonna tell you that how to identify the quadrant for the large angles. So let's understand the angle system. So this is the positive direction of x-axis, and we say that in the positive direction of x-axis we measure any angle. So if I want to measure the 30 degree, then how do we measure? So we take 30 degree with respect to positive direction of x-axis. So it means, let's say 30 will come like this, this will be the 30 degree. Now here if I ask you where the 0 degree angle will lie, so obviously that time the initial ray and the terminal ray will be at the same position. It means this position. So I can confidently say that the 0 degree will lie here itself. So here I'll write down that 0 degree. Next, if I'll ask you where 90 degree will lie, so 90 degree is nothing but this line with respect to positive direction of x-axis. So whenever we get 90 degree, we get this line. So here I'll say it is 90 degree or pi by 2. Similarly, this will be 180 degree or pi radians. Then this will be 3 pi by 2 radians, or I can say it is 270 degree. Next, if I add 90 in this, then I get 360 degree, or I can say it is 2 pi radians. Next, if I add more 90 degree in this, then I get 5 pi by 2. Next, if I add more 90 degree, then I get 3 pi. Next, if I add more 90 degree, then we get 7 pi by 2. And so on, if I'll do, then here I'll get 4 pi, then I'll get 6 pi. Here we will get 9 pi by 2, then we'll get 13 pi by 2, and so on. Here we'll get 5 pi, then 7 pi, and so on. And here we'll get 11 pi by 2, then 15 pi by 2, and so on. Now my friends, let's observe it carefully. So if we'll see this positive direction of x-axis, then we are getting the angles which are multiple of pi, and if you'll see here, then that multiple is even multiple, I'll say. So here 0 degree, then 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi. So every time I am getting the even pi. So tomorrow if I'll ask you where 40 pi will lie, then you can confidently say that it will be at positive direction of x-axis. Similarly, if you observe the negative direction of x-axis, it is again multiple of pi but odd pi's. So here we are getting all odd pi. So tomorrow if I'll ask you where the 53 pi will lie, then it will be at negative direction of x-axis. Now let's see the positive direction of y-axis. So here you'll see that first value that we got is pi by 2, and the next values are 4 greater than each value. So they are basically in arithmetic progression. So here you can see it is 5 pi by 2 after pi by 2, then 9 pi by 2, then 13 pi by 2. So the always the difference is constant. So if I want to represent this, then you can see here that it is a table of 4 plus 1. So here I can say it is 4 times n plus 1 into pi by 2. This is the pattern which I am getting at the positive direction of y-axis. Similarly, at the downside, that is negative direction of y-axis, what we are getting here, we are starting with 3 pi by 2, then again the series is in arithmetic progression. That is next step 7 pi by 2, the next value 11 pi by 2, the next one is 15 pi by 2. So if I want to summarize this, then it will be 4n minus 1 pi by 2. So you can see here that in the table of 4 we can get 16, and if I'll subtract 1 from the 16, I'll get 15 pi by 2. Similarly, 4 3s are 12, 12 minus 1 11 pi by 2, 4 2s are 8, 8 minus 1 7 pi by 2. So guys, here at the positive direction of x-axis we will say it is 4n plus 1 pi by 2, at the negative direction of y-axis we will say 4n minus 1 pi by 2. So after this, how to identify the quadrant? So let's come on this point. So guys, whenever angle will be given to you, what you have to do? So you have to divide the given angle with 90 degree. So by dividing it with 90 degree, you will get the multiple of 90. So here I'll say you will get like this, that is n pi by 2 plus or minus theta. So let's say the angle is given as 290 degree. So if I'll divide 290 degree, here I'll show you, if you'll divide the 290 degree with 90 degree, then you'll get 9 3s are 270 and the 20 as the remainder. So we can say that it is 3 into 90 degree plus 20 degree. So here we got the form like this, that is n pi by 2, where n is 3, this is pi by 2, I can represent it in the terms of pi by 2. So here we got the form n pi by 2 plus theta, and theta is 20 degree. So it means we have represented the given angle in terms of n pi by 2 plus or minus theta. Now what we have to do here? So whenever you will represent it in form of n pi by 2 plus or minus theta, you have to check how this n is behaving, whether this n is kind of 4n plus 1. It means this n belongs to 1, 5, 9, 13, or this n belongs to 3, 7, 11, 15. So here if you'll see, then my n is 3. So this 3 comes here. So this 3 pi by 2 means the negative direction of y-axis. So you just have to find out where that n pi by 2 lies. Okay. Now the rule is, whenever we represent angle in terms of n pi by 2 plus or minus theta, that time sine remains sine. So the rule is, whenever we find out the given angle in terms of n pi by 2 plus or minus theta, that time the sine becomes cos or cos becomes sine. Similarly, tan becomes cot or cot becomes tan. and sec becomes cosec and cosec becomes sec. So I'll take one example over here. So let's say I've got an angle which I've taken just now, that is 290 degree. So let's say if someone is asking me what is sine of 290 degree, so here I would say it is sine of 3 times pi by 2 plus 20 degree. So according to this rule, sine becomes cos, hence my value will be cos of 20 degree. Now I have not decided the sine yet. So this is the step number 1. That is, we will always identify the pattern. That is, whether we are getting n pi by 2 plus or minus theta, or the next pattern is n pi plus or minus theta. Now you must be thinking that how we would get n pi plus or minus theta. So friends, let me tell you one example. Now let's say you have got the angle as 420 degree. So to get the pattern, we will always divide it with 90 degree. So by dividing it with 90 degree, you will get 96 360 degree, and 60 degree remains as the remainder. So we will represent this as 6 times 90 degree, that is 6 times pi by 2 plus 60 degree. So guys, if you see here carefully, that this n is even number, it means I can divide this number with 2, and hence here I'll get 3 pi plus 60 degree. So it means here I'm getting the pattern as n pi plus or minus theta. So to get this pattern, we are still dividing it with 90 degree only, or pi by 2 radians. So for this pattern, we should get this n as even number. So whenever n is even, that time we will get n pi plus or minus theta pattern, and whenever this n is odd, that time we will get n pi by 2 plus or minus theta pattern. Now let's come back to the problem. So here I'll write that sine of 420 degree, so this is nothing but sine of 6 pi by 2 plus 60 degree. So this is nothing but sine of 3 pi plus 60 degree. So guys, let me tell you one more rule. Whenever we get the pattern as n pi plus or minus theta, that time sine remains sine, or cos remains cos, and so on. That is, tan remains tan, cot remains cot, sec remains sec, and cosec remains cosec. So here I'll say it is sine of 60 degree only. So because of this 3 pi, we got sine as it is, and 60 degree, which is our theta, which we copied it down. Now let's see how to identify the quadrant. So if you'll observe here, then here we are getting sine 3 pi by 2 plus 20 degree, and I told you that 3 pi by 2 means the negative direction of y axis. So when we are saying 3 pi by 2 plus 20, it means our angle is gonna be 20 degree more than this 3 pi by 2. So it means our angle is gonna lie in the fourth quadrant. So understand the concept, friends, that whenever we have plus some angle, then that angle lies in the next quadrant with respect to that line. So let's say this is my reference line and I have plus theta, so my angle will lie in first quadrant. Similarly, if I have this n pi by 2 pattern with negative theta, it means if I want to subtract the theta, then that time with respect to this reference line, my angle will lie in the fourth quadrant. So whenever it is plus theta, it will go in the next quadrant. Whenever it is negative theta, it will come in the previous quadrant. So now, if this is the reference line, if I have plus theta, then it will go in the second quadrant, and if I have minus theta, then it will go in the first quadrant. Now, if you'll see here, then 3 pi by 2 is this reference line and plus 20, therefore this angle will lie in the fourth quadrant. So if you'll see the next one, it is 3 pi. Now 3 pi is this line, that is odd pi line. So for odd pi line, plus 60 degree, so I have plus theta, so obviously it is gonna lie in the third quadrant. So here my angle will lie in fourth quadrant, and here my angle will lie in the third quadrant. So guys, I taught you the method to identify the quadrant with respect to reference line. So what you have to remember over here is the values. So on the positive direction of x-axis we get even pi's, on negative direction we get odd pi's, on the positive direction of y-axis we get 4n plus 1 pi by 2 pattern, and the negative direction of y-axis we get 4n minus 1 pi by 2 pattern. After that, if we have plus theta, then that quadrant will be next to the reference line, and if we have minus theta, then the quadrant will be previous to the reference line. So we have seen how to identify the quadrant in step number 1. Now in step number 2, we will learn how to give the sign with respect to the quadrant system. So in step number 2, let's see the quadrant system once again. So now here, as we have seen that in first quadrant all ratios are positive, or all trigonometric functions are positive. In the second quadrant, sine cosec positive, third one tan cot positive, and fourth one cosine sec positive. So as we have seen in the previous step, that how to identify the quadrant. So here we got fourth quadrant, and here we got third quadrant. So now let's observe the sign for fourth quadrant and third quadrant. So here in the fourth quadrant we say that cos and sec are positive, but our question was sign. It means in the fourth quadrant sign is negative, hence the negative sign will be given to this answer. Similarly, in the third quadrant tan and cot are positive, but here we have sign. So sign is negative in the third quadrant, hence we are giving the negative sign to the final answer. So by doing this, or by using this reference, we can identify the sign of the value. So by these two steps we can find out the value of any trigonometric angle which is having larger angle. So without using calculator, it is possible within 2 seconds by just remembering the two steps, that is identify the quadrant and identify the sign. That's it. So let's see some more examples. So let's say if I want to find out sec of 3660 degree. Now this angle is very large. Now how to get the value? So as I said, first of all we will identify the quadrant, and to identify the quadrant we have to divide the given angle with 90 degree. So let's divide it. So we have 3660, divide it with 90. So what we'll get? So it is 90 forza 360. Here we will get 0060. Next 90 zeroza 0. So 60 will remain as remainder. So we are getting this as 40 into 90, that is 40 pi by 2 plus 60. But my friends, let me tell you, it is 20 pi plus 60 degree, because this is even number. So here I'll write that it is equal to sec of, it is 40 pi by 2 plus 60 degree, which is equal to sec of 20 pi plus 60 degree. Now guys, let's identify the quadrant. So 20 pi, 20 is even number. So even number means positive direction of x-axis. Let me tell you the diagram. So it is positive direction of x-axis, that even pi. So 20 pi plus 60 degree. So whenever it is plus, it will go in the next quadrant. So next quadrant is first quadrant. So this angle will lie in the first quadrant. So we have identified the quadrant. Step number 2, identify the side. So in step number 1, we have seen the quadrant. So with quadrant, we have seen the pattern as well. So pattern was like this, 20 pi plus theta. So sine remains sine, cos remains cos. So here we have sec. So sec remains sec and the angle is 60 degree. Now step number 2, that is identify the sine. So since the angle lies in first quadrant, in first quadrant all trigonometric functions are positive, hence the final value will be positive. So you just have to find out the sec 60 degree, which is very easy, which is 1 upon cos of 60 degree. So guys, what is cos of 60 degree? You all know that it is half. So it will be 1 upon 1 by 2 and the final answer will be 2. So guys, we have seen here that how to find out the value of trigonometric angles without using the calculator. Thank you.